In this video, we're going to go through the most popular Softr blocks and their core functionality. That way, when you're thinking about building your mobile or web app with Softr, you have a better understanding of the capabilities. Softr's core concept is the building block. So when you're building out your app, you have over 100 different blocks to choose from, each with their own capabilities and functionality, allowing you to easily customize your app for your needs, all without code. With the blocks, you have the ability to arrange them in any particular order, group them into pages, all while defining a specific set of relationships and links within your application, as well as external parties. So let's take a closer look. All right, so I've opened up a new app that I've created via our inventory tracking system template. So as you can see, this template already consists of a few blocks. So to add a block, all you'll do is simply hover over this plus icon, click, and then you'll see two options here in the sidebar, static and dynamic. Understanding the difference between these two blocks is important. So static blocks allow you to display visual information that is, well, static. As you can see, we have things like hero images here, gallery images. You can display your team members. You can do a call to action if you would like. And let's see what else we have. In addition, we can do pricing. You can showcase your team, testimonials, FAQs. And in addition, you can also add a site-wide header as well as footer. So static blocks essentially can allow you to create a standalone website or landing page. However, the true power of Softr comes from what we call dynamic blocks. With dynamic blocks, you can visually display information via your data source, which as of the time of me recording this includes Airtable as well as Google Sheets, but there will be more to come. So this really allows you to extend far beyond a static application or simple website as it introduces functionality. Some of that functionality could include user groups, which allows certain users to log in, create an account, see certain information. You can do payment and memberships. You can also do filtering and sorting of information. You can also gather information via forms. There's so much you can do, so let's dive a little bit into that. Before we dive into the blocks, let's first take a quick look at individual block settings. With every block, you have the option to move the block up or down. Couldn't really tell that time. There we go. You can also delete blocks individually. You can duplicate. You can also make blocks visible or invisible. And we have this cool feature where you can copy individual blocks over to other apps within your Softr Studio. So on the right-hand side, you'll notice when you click into your blocks that you see the block settings. Within the settings, you can edit the block name. You can also change the block level styles, as you'll see here with the paddings and margins. In addition to that, under the Features tab, you can edit out any of the content as well as style individual content. And then you can also update any assets to make it customized to your app. In addition, you might have some buttons as an option, and then every setting has the embed block available on certain plans as long as you publish your app. Lastly, you'll notice under static block settings that there is the option of editing the visibility. So this will come in handy as you think about different user groups and defining who you want to see certain content and who should be restricted from seeing certain content. You can also toggle device visibility as well, but we're going to get into that in another video. In addition, let's go up to a dynamic block setting. When you click into dynamic block settings, you're gonna see additional tabs up here. So let's actually move to one that I've already connected. Okay, so here you'll see that you have the data option. Data is where you connect your data source. So I've connected to my Airtable and I've chosen my Airtable base. And that has now allowed this information to display visually with just a few extra steps that I'm gonna get into. So under the data tab, you'll connect your data source for dynamic blocks. You'll also be able to choose other settings such as sorting, and you can also add conditional filters, which again, we'll get into in another video. In the next tab, features, you'll be able to add filters such as also a search bar, and you can assign the item fields. meaning if I want this to be the photo, then I need to tell Airtable, hey, Airtable, I want to assign this content into the images field in my Airtable database. Again, this is a concept that we will cover in later videos in depth. So most of the static blocks are pretty straightforward. They allow you to build a static website or a landing page via all of our static blocks. So for this video, I'm actually going to go through in more detail our dynamic blocks so you can have an idea of the different capabilities of the Softr app. However, we will have individual videos available that go deeper into each one of these dynamic blocks because there is a lot that you can do with them. So let's go ahead and get started. First up, we have the form block. So let's add a couple and see what it looks like right here. So using the form block, you can do simple things like allowing your users to get in touch with you. You can also collect information from your users. All of it, again, is going to be stored in Airtable or Google Sheets, or you can also send the data somewhere else using an integration like Zapier or Make. In addition, you can also actually use forms to update data in real time within your app. And the true power of forms actually comes with hidden fields. So hidden fields will allow you to send and match hidden data that the user doesn't see. Again, we're going to get into that in an individual video so you can have a deeper understanding of it. But for the sake of this overview video, let's move on. So next up, we have user accounts. User accounts are pretty straightforward as well, but also quite powerful. So they allow you to create an app that allows you to have users create accounts. They can log in. They can see certain information that you've designated for them. They can also retrieve their password, edit their profile. And we have lots of different options for logging in as well. As you'll see here, we have single sign-on. We also have Google sign-on. And we also have texting, I think, as well. Yeah. So lots of options here. Again, we'll get into another video. Okay. So next up, we have payment blocks. Pretty straightforward, right? Payment blocks allow you to set up paid memberships. You can charge your users for accessing certain sections, certain pages, blocks, via your Softr app with Stripe. So again, we'll get into that later, but just know that that is a dynamic block that's available to you. All right, so after the payment block, we have the list and the list details block. These are like best friends and some of our most versatile and most used blocks within Softr. So we have a whole video on this that goes in depth, but at a high level, this block allows you to link your data source as we've seen before. So let's just quickly link. I'll choose client portal and I'll choose the table as people. And then again, like we said before, I need to assign the different content via my field. So I want the H1 to be my person's name here. And then let's just also have the image show up so you can really see the power of this. There we go. So this is all pulling from my Airtable database. Again, we're going to show you a whole video that goes into the Airtable database as well. But as you can see, this block just allows you to seamlessly link your data source so you can build any collection of items. Some quick examples are a job board, product listings. You could include employee directories, employee portals, could do ranked lists. There's so many different options. The block has a number of different layouts as well. So you have a lot of different styling to choose from, functionality. And then in addition, you have the list details block, which actually links to your list block. So you'll typically put a list details block on a separate page. And so say I want to click into this Joyce list right here and I want to see this Joyce information, then I can link to this list details block that will then show up all of the information about Joyce on a separate page. Again, this is very high level. We're going to go into detail, but just to get you thinking about this. Let's see. Next up under dynamic, we have the table block. So the table block works exactly the same way as a list block, but it displays the data from Airtable and Google Sheets in a table layout. So this block actually has a few unique properties, such as the ability for users to download the table data in a CSV file. We can also do an XML file as well. You can also enable a checkbox feature that updates your data source in real time. So for example, a user can come in and click to change the status, and that will actually change the status on your Airtable database as well, which is the case with everything within Softr. When you edit data in Softr, it also automatically edits in Airtable immediately. All right, so what else do we have? We also have the calendar block, so let's add that. Calendar block, pretty straightforward. It allows you to show your data in a calendar form, similar to list and table block. This can be really useful for displaying events, potentially project timelines. All right, let's keep moving on. Next up, we have the Kanban block. It allows you again to display your data from Airtable or Google Sheets, but in the Kanban board layout. So this is actually really great for project management use cases. It really functions very similarly to a Trello board or any type of Kanban block that you might be used to. It also, again, updates your data in real time as you change it within the app. All right, moving on. Next up, we have two types of chart blocks. Now, chart blocks are available on our business plan or higher, just so you are aware of that. So the first chart block that is available to you essentially allows you to display visual data through graphs, bar charts, pie charts, and more. There's tons of different options here. And again, you're going to link it to your data source. So this is a really great way to display reports, dashboards, information to a key group of people, such as clients, investors, or employees. So the second chart block we have is the organizational chart. This can be a visual way to showcase your organization's hierarchy with employee information displayed dynamically. Pretty cool, right? If you're building an employee portal or a team intranet, this can be a great block to include. Okay, moving right along. Next up, we have the comment block. Using this block, you can allow your users to add comments to your Softr app. This can be of use in many ways. Some of the most common use cases are on blogs, as well as project management tasks and client portals. It allows clients to, you know, essentially comment on project status and ask questions. But there's several different use cases for this. And again, it'll sync with your Airtable if that's what you would like. Lastly, and not certainly not least, we have the map block. So let's pull that up. Perfect. This allows you to display a list of locations from Airtable or Google Sheets through Google Maps. So if you have multiple locations or you want to display information geographically, this is the block for you. You just need to connect your data source and then you'll be on your way. Okay, that was a lot of information. Let's just quickly recap. Softr's core concept is the building block. As you begin to think about the type of app that you need to build, you'll use the different blocks to bring that app to life. Now we have static blocks and dynamic blocks. Static allow you to build, well, a static website or a landing page. The true power of Softr comes from the dynamic blocks. Dynamic blocks allow you to connect to an external data source, allowing you to build fully functioning web and mobile apps. Pretty cool, right? So we've gone into a lot in this video. Let's jump into future videos as we go in depth into the full capabilities of what Softr can do. See you in the next one.